Hello and welcome to my reaction to episode 7 of Gare Zero. Sorry, I had a brain fart for a moment. So, last episode, a fair amount happened. We're still in the flashback, of course. We finally really met the kid with the blue butterfly. He fought the white-haired girl and seemingly killed her. Also, the doctor from Kagura's school, the school nurse, I guess, was controlled by one of the Sparadite thing, and Kagura killed her. Yeah, and the episode ended with that, basically. But I'm pretty sure Isayama-me, the white-haired girl, is not dead. I mean, she might have been dead because it just stabbed her in the head, but she wouldn't just... It's not the end of her use. It's probably gonna bring him back, and maybe she's gonna be with the bad guy now. I mean, she's done nothing really so far, so I would be surprised if she's just dead, and that's it. So episode 7, let's see where any of this lead. Episode 7 in 3, 2, 1. Butterfly. That's a cool shot. Yeah, okay. I mean, of course she wasn't dead. She did nothing yet. I'm not surprised. And good, I would say. I like her character design, so. What a waste it would have been if she just dead like that. After doing so little. Now we pass the halfway point of the show. I still think it's not perfect. The way they started the show with two episodes in the present, ending on such a cliffhanger, and now we're like five episodes in the flashback. And we're not even close to having any clue about what happened or anything. I do feel like it's not handled that well. I'm still enjoying the show. I like the character. But I'm just saying. Chains of Blame, episode 7. I will still say what I said last episode. She could have saved her because the parasite thing was bigger than her head, so she could have just stabbed the top. But I guess, yeah, she was shocked, so she didn't think about it or something. Why are you mad at her? She just saved your ass. Trauma. once again, it's a bit of a problem for me. At the beginning of the show with her, she was fighting monster. So we already know she gets over it. So it's kind of like, eh. I'm not very good at explaining, but I think you understand what's my problem with the fact that it started with the present and now with this long flashback, and it's a bit too long. Fair enough. I mean, this guy wants his daughter, so... Oh. Okay. So she's still with her father and shit. She hasn't joined the dark side yet. But there's definitely something, obviously. She was dead. She was killed. New school nurse. So we're doing the same thing again. She's saying the exact same thing. For a second, I was almost thinking, is it the same episode? Did I fuck something up? But it's on purpose. Okay. Coulda got to push in the trauma. I'm assuming the nurse. What the fuck is wrong with you? They saw what the fuck happened and they still say that. It's pretty dumb. You should be the one eating her. She deserves a good bitch slap to set her straight. I mean, this is the classic thing that they do, but it doesn't really work here. They saw the fucking nurse as a fucking zombie killing people. Okay, at least it's not drug debt, it's already resolved. Good, because that was pissing me off. Alright. Good. She feels something. She definitely did. Classic. Was that someone we know? Some shit is going down. In the two first episodes, it was a thing that Kaguya had surpassed Yumi. Okay. Is it the moment? No, okay. Draw. Okay, not yet. Fair enough. Well, you will support her, but what about her dad, for example? Well, obviously, we know she doesn't quit. I mean, oh shit. Well, my man's dead. Absolutely dead. That's not true. Well, she might surpass her like physically and shit, but mentally, she definitely needs Yumi. I mean, it's the same with anyone. Not everyone likes you. Nice. Well, they already kissed, so. Pretty sure they won't be some dinner tonight. So Kagura is gonna be the one to find the dead body. Right after one trauma, let's get another one. Nice. Nice. Okay, the relationship really went faster than I was expecting. Oh boy, here we go. Let's get another spoon of PTSD. I wonder if this is what will the initial incident that will set off Yomin into the dark pass. If it is what happened, there's still no clue whether or not she went down the dark pass or something controlled her to go down the dark pass. It's still not clear. Oh shit, she has to be the one to do it. To tell her. Oh, he's not dead. So he's dying. No, he's already dead. Okay, makes sense. And the ceremony of passing on to Yomi hasn't happened. So I'm pretty sure the brother and the white-haired girl are going to fuck some shit so that Yomi doesn't get anything. Well, obviously that was the plan, killing him for that, I imagine. Alright, good episode. A few things pissed me off, but nothing major. Things are finally really getting into motion. You know, let me try to find it and tell you which one it is of the Black Lagoon ending that this reminds me of, so you can see how similar they are. I think, yeah, it's the first one. Black Lagoon ending, don't look behind. Start with a shot of Revy's footstep. Okay, it's mostly just Revy's foot from behind, and then at the very end it turned to her facing the camera. Okay, so it's not that similar, but similar enough, yeah. So yeah, it's Black Lagoon ending, don't look behind. Alright, yeah. Whereabouts of revenge. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I mean, shit are definitely getting real now. So quite a bit to look forward to. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.